Xin chào and welcome to the Discover Vietnam TV. And today we are coming to the village by the beautiful river and come to watch the farmer are working with the water buffalo. Yes. Yes. And this is the dry farming with the land for cereals growing. For cereal growing. Yes. And today the farmers are taking the water buffalo with him to get the land and get the soil plow up. Yes. 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 So they are working very hard. You see, the soil and the land is now being plowed up. Yes, with the water buffalo. Yeah. Ooh. Yes. Yes. So it is the normal work of a farmer, of a daily working of the farmer. And I think they are working together for a long time. So now would be the hard job for them, of course, but they get used to do it. And of course, after this day working, the water buffalo will be get very good food with fresh grass and something else for the, you know, the food for the winter, because it's now going to be the winter in Vietnam. Yes. You know, because the Vietnam is an agriculture country, so in the village, in the countryside village, every family normally own one water buffalo like this, or about half of the village. The villagers are owning a buffalo for year-round purpose of farming in the rice paddy field for the wet rice season, or for the cereals and vegetable and some seed in the soy farming like this, and to grow some special veggie for supplying themselves lives and for selling into the market to earn a little bit money. So farming is the main job of the Vietnamese people who are living in the countryside village. And even they don't have to buy some thing for their own meal, but they need to buy pork or other to combine with the veggies and with the cereals that they are growing the farm like this. Yes. And you see the soy farming season for veggies growing and for the seed like beans or green beans or peanut. And we are looking at the, you know, some villagers who are working now on the soy in the farm. Cô ơi, đất này mình trồng cái gì á cô?
Đậu không?
Cũng là đậu hết à?
Đậu.
Chỉ có đậu lạc thôi à?
Đậu.
Còn nếu mà bắp với lại đậu xanh thì trồng khi nào ạ?
Chưa.
Dạ.
Mùa gạt lúa xong, mùa này thu hoạch xong, bắp cũng có tỉa một tỉa bên kia rồi.
Dạ dạ.
Dạ. Nó tùy theo chủ.
Dạ. Vậy thì khoảng mấy tháng là mình có củ để mình thu hoạch hả cô?
4 tháng là có củ mà.
4 tháng là lâu á cô hả?
Ừ.
Dạ.
Hả, yes. Chỗ này tới 4 tháng là mới kiếm trái em.
Dạ, rứa thì cũng vất vả cô nhỉ. Dạ, khó khăn nhỉ.
Dạ.
Dạ, con tưởng là nó ngắn hơn lúa chứ té ra nó còn lâu hơn lúa nữa. Wow.
Cái khác cũng như nhau mà, cũng như nhau.
Dạ.
Như nhau lúa luôn.
Dạ.
Yes, so ladies and gentlemen, I asked the farmers about the process of making and growing the peanut in the soil. They respond with you know, with a very warmly explanation that this is the season of peanut only for the soil next to the river like this, and the season would be about 4 months. I mean they are growing the soil, I'm sorry, they are growing the seed of the peanut into the soil for 4 months, and then they will get fruit in about 4 months later. You know that this fruit could be grow in the soil only, I mean in the land, it's not the flowers and seeds on the top of the tree like you have known. Yes. Mình có bỏ phân gì dưới không cô? Dạ. Nhưng mà phân này là phân phân tươi hay là phân đạm, phân 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 hóa học? Phân đạm mà. Dạ.
Nào mà tao có lắm. Bỏ mạnh cô mà. Ở trong cô họ bỏ phân cúc cô lăng kìa. Họ bỏ cà lên, họ bỏ phân phân chi mịn mịn mà phân mà. Phân mỏng mò mà mịn 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 mà một.
Trong đầu này thì có phải tưới nước không cô hè?
Không tưới nước cần.
Không cần à?
Vụ đông là không cần.
Dạ dạ.
Trong vườn mà nén quá khô kìa.
Dạ dạ. À vậy thì cũng không mất nhiều công lắm cô. À nhưng mà có cỏ chứ.
Cỏ mà sao bút vô gốc.
Dạ. Con nghĩ là cỏ sẽ lên nhiều lắm ạ.
Lên nhiều lắm chứ.
Dạ.
Lên chi mà giờ bà bơm xe kìa.
Dạ.
Nhớ mà mới chết bớt bỏ cỏ cô.
Dạ.
Nhưng thường ví dụ
à dạ 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 đúng rồi dạ 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 về thì cũng đỡ tốn công bớt đi.
Wow, you are looking at the seed in the soil, right? On the surface of the soil like this. You see the soil with the peanut seed. Aha, and then they will fill up the seed in the soil. And you know, I asked them if they need to watering regularly or not, and they say no need, just about once a month or something like that. In the case the farm is located by the river like this one, or if the farm is so far from the water resource, there's no need to watering. But the problem for the farmer is they need to clear the wild grass after growing some weeks. Yes, some week later from this surface there would be a lot of wild grass to be cleaned out or clear up. That is the reason to make they and they are now quite hard working for a day long. It is about, you know, 5 p.m. now of the day in Vietnam, but they haven't finished their job yet. Wow, we wish that they would be earning some money for them, and seed of the peanut would be growing very well, and they will have a good season of harvesting later after 4 months. Hey, and now I'm gonna talk with the farmers who are working on the soy field to grow the peanut. Yes, he's going to put the seed of peanut into the land to make the season of the peanut on the farming, and this is one of the jobs that he's doing about twice a year to grow the peanut in the soil like this. And if any farm are in the water, they are growing the rice. But if the farm are, you know, dry like this without any water, they will grow some of the vegetable and some of cereals like green beans or peanut and something else like the fruit and like flowers and sesame and something else like that. And Vietnam is an agriculture country, so we are growing and growing the rice, the vegetable and something else to supply ourselves, right? So we are not really buy everything from the market, but we grow in the garden or in the farm, in the field to feed ourselves, or we call to supply ourselves. That is the tradition lifestyle of Vietnam. Yes. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your watching with us today. Thank you for subscribing the channel of Discover Vietnam TV. We hope that you will keep watching with us for next video and like this video, share to your friends and share on your social media platform. That could be highly appreciated. All right, thank you and bye-bye.
Đây. Đây không? Đây.
Chú cày hết cái lô này mới về chú à? Dạ.
Đây.
Đất này có nặng không hả chú? Ủa, gió ướt hay sao mà nặng chứ?
Cỏ.
Cỏ à, cỏ dính. Dạ đúng rồi. Yes, so ladies and gentlemen, the farmers and the water buffalo are at the moment working very hard. It is so so bad for the water buffalo, right? It is a lovely animal, but you know, because the farmers are you know, buying them or growing, feeding them for a long time to get the labor force for farming, so the water buffalo need to work with them. The water buffalo is no free time in this season. I think and I hope that the water buffalo will be free after finishing the farming season by the farmer, with the farmer like this. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the, you know, we don't want to showcase the, you know, the bad behavior by the people to the animal, or especially to the farmers and the water buffalo. But because in Vietnam, the agriculture is the main job, is the main industry, so growing
vegetable and no other choice. No other choice.
Yes. And you see the land plow up, but the land is the fill up with a lot of white grass. So I think after this, they need to, to filter out the grass out of the soil to have a good land, to have a clear soil and land to grow the seed into the soil.
Dạ rồi, cô này gửi lời chào bạn bè và khán giả của con xí này đó. Cô có gửi lời thăm gì đến ạ? Sau này hàng hóa có nhiều, ý là thu hoạch đầu nhiều, cô có muốn bán cho bà con ở nước ngoài của con không? Con đang làm video cho người nước ngoài đó.
Không có món, ví dụ là nhiều đọt thì con đánh là mấy cô bán cho câu.
Dạ dạ rồi, ok.
Cô cũng gửi là chúc mấy câu sức khỏe, hạnh phúc.
Dạ, tốt quá, dạ. Rồi, thay mặt những người nước ngoài và những người bạn con đang xem video này, con cảm ơn cô. Và chúc cô và những người bà con ở đây là có một mùa màng bội thu sắp tới nha. All right, thank you so much. She wish you all, our audience and our subscribers, a good health and enjoyable time with the channel. And they wish that we will come and buy the product for them after everything. So we will come back here 4 months later. Thank you. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.